Gunnar site is a so-called abandoned mining site. It was started in the 1950s and abandoned in the 1960s. It was actually the first uranium project in Saskatchewan and one of the first in Canada.
As of 1964, everybody was off the site. They locked things up and basically they just left everything as is.
In those times, of course, the environmental standards were much lower, if existed at all.
Now we're working on trying to remediate decades of deterioration and scavenging that occurred on the site over time. The province of Saskatchewan approached SRC to ask if we would be willing to manage the cleanup of the Gunnar Mine site.
The main objective of Cleans project is to eliminate or mitigate all these environmental hazards associated with Gunnar site and some other sites.
So there were, you know, over 20 structures where people used to live that had to be taken down. There were a number of fishing shacks. There was a mall, a school, the headframe, two acid plants, you know, the mill, a powerhouse, and many other buildings that supported these structures. One of the big hazards on the Gunnar Mine site, aside from the physical hazards, was the asbestos that's on site. During the demolition work that SRC oversaw, one of the first steps was to remove the friable and the non-friable asbestos. Now the friable asbestos, because it can get into the air, it can float around in the air, what the contractors would do would be to wet it down to make sure that the fiber count was low in the air. And they also added soap to the water, which would stick to the fibers and keep them down into the wetted surface. We worked closely in discussions with our asbestos expert and Saskatchewan Environment, and they had these little pumps that were pumping the air and monitoring, you know, the fiber counts in the air. And then they would use that to modify their work as necessary. And they would also use that to select the appropriate personal protective equipment to protect the workers. On a project of this scale, safety is the very top priority. All activities on the site are planned in advance and they're captured in safety plans that are discussed with regulators and approved. There were daily safety meetings where every worker on site had to attend, including SRC staff. There were opportunities for people to discuss issues and to raise them, and then those would get captured and resolved. One of the big milestones that we're really proud of is that we managed to meet the expectations of our clients and the governments and the people that live in the communities in terms of taking down the buildings in a safe manner and alleviating a number of safety risks that have existed there for several decades.
At the moment, Cleans project and Gunnar part of the Cleans project is at the stage of environmental assessment. We tested all the affected environments, and there is contamination of aquatic environments, lands, and air.
There's unconfined tailings that you can see. There's, you know, there's a pit, an open pit, and also there's waste rock piles, you know, which have seepage that feeds into Lake Athabasca.
We collected a lot of information and now understand the sources of the environmental contamination and understand the risks associated with the Gunnar site much better than we knew these risks before. Having this information in hand, we can plan the real remediation activities in much more detail and with much more reliability.
The biggest thing that I think about the Gunnar project is just the sheer diversity of people with various skill sets that have worked together to make it happen. There's no way to get it done without all the different expertise, And the commitment, the sheer commitment by all the people that participated and continue to participate on this project. It's basically one of the biggest challenges that I've ever had the honor of participating in, and I really love it, and it feels good to be part of a solution.